Hello fellow reef keepers, this is Waylon from Marine Depot, and I'm here to talk to you about a common reef aquarium pest called Cyanobacteria, or Cyano for short. A lot of people think Cyano is a type of algae, but it's actually a photosynthetic bacteria. It's slimy and often grows in sheets that can be siphoned or blown off of the rocks or substrates quite easily. It comes in different colors like red, green, or deep purple. In the ocean, there are species of cyanobacteria that cause toxic red tides, which can be detrimental to the entire ecosystem where they bloom. In our aquariums, the cyanobacteria is not toxic per se, but can have some nasty side effects. Not only is it ugly, cyano will shade and outcompete your corals for real estate, thus blocking photosynthesis. If the conditions are right, cyano can grow quickly and can cover any surface in your tank. Your aquarium can't really catch cyano from another tank because it's pretty much always around and in your tank. Cyano outbreaks are caused primarily because of elevated nutrients and insufficient flow. These conditions then allow cyano to grow rapidly and outcompete other beneficial bacteria and algae in your tank. Light spectrum and bacterial balance come into play as well, but in most situations, these are only secondary contributors. Cyanobacteria feeds off the waste in your tank called detritus, and will likely grow in areas where this waste accumulates. These areas are the sand bed, live rock, and even your filtration compartments. Cyano loves dead spots in the tank where water flow is very low, so make sure you have a high enough flow rate in your tank and that all corners of your tank have excellent water movement. This helps to keep the detritus suspended for easy removal and prevents waste from building up in one particular area, which is how 99% of cyanobacteria arise. Wave makers like the Ecotech Vortec MP10 and the MaxSpec Gyre are awesome for achieving flow patterns that inhibit cyano growth because they move large volumes of water. High water flows help to eliminate dead spots throughout your entire aquarium without the need of multiple pumps. You should siphon cyano and detritus off your rocks and substrate immediately upon noticing it in your tank, and then daily thereafter. If cyano has a fuel source, it will grow back almost right away. Also, be sure to change your filter media often and clean up any uneaten food within an hour of feeding. Siphoning cyano and detritus out of your tank will really help your efforts to beat cyanobacteria. You'll be removing the locked up nutrients that cyano has consumed. You'll also be diluting your tank with clean salt water, helping to reduce the general waste levels in the tank. Test your nitrate and phosphate levels regularly because these parameters are a direct indication of your waste levels in your tank. Elevated phosphates and nitrates mean your tank is not efficiently processing the nutrients that are going into the system. You can reduce nitrate and phosphates in a variety of ways. The best option is a frequent and consistent water change schedule. Of course, proper biological filtration along with an efficient protein skimmer and efficient mechanical filtration are also necessary. In situations with a heavy bioload, you might want to consider using media or chemical solutions to target and remove phosphates and nitrates. GFO, or granular ferric oxide, such as Aquamax Phosphate Out Pro or Rolifos, are excellent at removing phosphates. The use of the liquid chemical lanthanum chloride is becoming a very popular way to remove phosphates rapidly, but it should be noted that this stuff works very quickly and you will have adverse effects on your tank and habitants if you do it too quickly and use it incorrectly. Biopellets are a popular solution for tanks with higher nitrate levels. This system actually utilizes bacteria to remove nitrates and is a great way to combat prolific cyanobacteria problems. Natural methods of nutrient control like refugiums or algae scrubbers, like the Clearwater external algae scrubber, will help reduce harmful nutrients as well. This natural method of nutrient control is becoming more and more prevalent in aquarium applications. It's become more commonplace in many successful filtration systems. After addressing your nutrients and flow inside the aquarium, 9 times out of 10 you can defeat cyano in just a few weeks. However, the problem can be so severe sometimes, so bad that you need to kill it off completely and start fresh. In these serious cases, you can do what's called a blackout, which means you turn off your lights and lay a blanket or tarp over the tank to block out any ambient light for 72 hours. Cyanobacteria cannot survive without light for this long, but your fish and corals will be fine. Just keep in mind that when the blackout is over, the cyano can bounce right back if you have not addressed the elevated waste and water flow issues. You might also look at one of these easy chemical remedies such as the Ultralife Red Slime Remover or Boyd's ChemiClean. These solutions help eradicate the cyanobacteria that is growing inside your tank. Ultralife Red Slime Remover and ChemiClean Red Slime Cyanobacteria Remover are at the top of the list because they are safe for all fish, corals, inverts, desirable microalgae, and nitrifying bacteria. They're simple to implement and fast acting. A couple things to note during a chemical treatment. Remove carbon or similar chemical filtration media that can remove the medication from your tank water. You will need to turn off your protein skimmer as well as your UV sterilizer and ozone generator if you have one. It is best to also add an aerostone to your system during treatment because oxygen levels can get quickly depleted. The aerostone will ensure this does not happen. An aerostone will also keep your pH stable during treatment. Always be prepared with extra salt water on hand because you will need to perform a substantial water change 24 to 48 hours after treatment. Although very rare, it is possible for cyano to grow on living coral. In this case, you can dip the coral with a coral dip like Coral RX Coral Dip. Swish and shake the coral well in the dip to remove or dislodge any cyanobacteria that is present, and then rinse in a separate container of salt water before placing it back into your tank. Your aquarium maintenance techniques will drastically affect what happens in your tank, so unless you have a strange desire to battle any one of these aquarium elements, don't let your waste levels become a problem in your tank to begin with. Something to understand about cyanobacteria and many of the algae problems that will arise in similar situations is that an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. Be sure to check out the Marine Depot blog and education center for articles containing more information about battling nuisance reef pests. We've included a few helpful links below. If you found our video helpful, subscribe to our channel to stay up to date on all the latest Marine Depot videos. Thank you for watching today. Please reach out to us anytime because we're here to help you succeed in keeping a beautiful saltwater aquarium.